During World War II, Nazi Germany's engineers created so many insane and fantastical weapons that they still astonish us today. One of Hitler's ideas was to develop a superweapon that could change the course of the war. We present to you a series of sketches about the mind-blowing weapons of the Third Reich, machines that were ahead of their time and still seem unbelievable even now. Dora, the colossal railway gun of Nazi Germany. Dora was a unique super-heavy railway artillery piece developed by Germany's Krupp company in the late 1930s. This massive gun was designed specifically to destroy heavily fortified targets, such as the French Maginot Line and the defensive fortifications along the German-Belgian border. In 1941, the weapon underwent live fire testing at a special military proving ground in the presence of Adolf Hitler, Albert Speer, and other high-ranking Wehrmacht officials. The test demonstrated that Dora met the technical requirements set out in the initial design specifications, even though some support mechanisms were still missing at the time. This monstrous weapon weighed over 1,350 tons, had a barrel length of 32 meters, and boasted an unprecedented caliber of 807 millimeters. It could fire two types of shells, nearly 5-ton high-explosive shells and 7-ton concrete-piercing shells, with an effective range of 25 to 37 kilometers. Due to its size, Dora was deployed only in very specific situations. Each shot from Dora unleashed a force comparable to a minor earthquake. Over 900 kilograms of gunpowder were consumed in a fraction of a second, just 6 milliseconds, producing a thunderous roar and propelling the massive projectile with overwhelming force. Operating such a weapon required an enormous logistical effort. More than 4,000 soldiers and technicians were involved in its transport, assembly, and maintenance. Dora saw combat only once, during the Siege of Sevastopol in 1942, where it was used to bombard Soviet fortifications. However, despite the scale of destruction it could theoretically inflict, its actual effectiveness was limited. By the later stages of World War II, the kind of tasks Dora was designed to perform were being handled more efficiently by ground attack aircraft and conventional bombers. In contrast to its massive size and low mobility, air raids offered greater flexibility, faster response times, and similar or even greater destructive power. Post-war assessments by military historians and artillery experts were not kind to Dora. Most concluded that, despite its engineering brilliance and psychological impact, the combat effectiveness of ultra-heavy artillery systems like Dora did not justify the enormous resources required for their operation and upkeep.